Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjalayammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. This is lecture number 10.2. We are going to solve problems in the clutch design. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the theory part of the clutch design, the various types of clutch and the design procedure, calculating the force and the torque transmitted in the clutch. And in this lecture, we solve few problems in the single plate and the cone clutch. So the learning outcome to the student at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in single plate, multi plate and cone clutch using under uniform pressure and wear conditions. Example number 1, a single plate clutch effective on both sides is required to transmit 25 kilowatt at 3000 rpm. Determine the outer and the inner diameter of the frictional surface if the coefficient of friction is 0.255. The ratio of diameters is 1.25 and the maximum pressure is not to exceed 0.1 newtons per millimeter square. Also determine the axial thrust to be provided by the springs. Assume uniform wear theory. This question was appeared in November 2006 and November 2008 question papers. And we write down the given data from the problem. The given data, the power to be transmitted is 25 kilowatt, the speed is 3000 rpm, the coefficient of friction is 0.255, diameter ratio capital D by small d, capital D is the outer diameter and small d is the inner diameter, and it is equal to capital R by small r, that is equal to 1.25. and the pressure equal to 0.1 newtons per millimeter square. Here both sides are effective and we have to use uniform wear theory. And from the power given, we have to calculate the torque to be transmitted by the clutch. Mt equal to P into 60 divided by 2 pi n. So 25,000 into 60 divided by 2 pi into 3000 equal to 79.62 newton meter. Then the torque is also given by, in terms of the axial force, 2 mu q into rm. So q is the axial force, rm is the mean radius, mu is the coefficient of friction, 2 for both side effective. And the axial thrust to be provided by the springs for uniform wear theory, q equal to 2 pi pa into r into capital R minus small r. Small r is the inner radius, capital R is the outer radius. Substituting the numerical values, q equal to 2 into 3.14 into 0.1 into 10 power 6 into small r, capital R equal to 1.25 times of small r minus r, that is equal to 1,57,000 r square. Then we calculate the mean radius for the uniform wear theory, rm equal to capital R plus small r divided by 2, 1.25 small r plus r divided by 2 equal to 1.125 r. So the inner diameter of the frictional disc. We take the Mt equation, Mt equal to 2 mu q into rm, which is 79.62 newton meter. Now Mt we calculated, so we substitute Mt is 79.62, so this is 2 into 0.255 into 1,57,000 into r square into 1.125 r equal to 79.62. So r to the power 3 equal to 79.62 divided by 90,078.75, which is 8.84 in 10 power minus 4. So solving the equation, we take cubic root, so r equal to 0.096 meter and the diameter equal to 0.192 meter. And then we calculate the outer diameter of the friction disc, capital D equal to 1.25 times of inner diameter, so 1.25 into 0.192 equal to 0.24 meter. Then the axial thrust provided by the spring, q equal to 1,57,000 r square, which is 1,57,000 into 0.096 square equal to 1,446.9 newton. And we write down the answer to the problem. The inner diameter small d equal to 19.2 centimeter, outer diameter capital D equal to 24 centimeter, axial thrust provided by the spring q equal to 1,446.9 newton. We take next example from May 2013 question paper. An automobile single plate clutch consists of two pairs of contacting surfaces. The inner and outer radii of the frictional plate are 120 mm and 250 mm respectively. The coefficient of friction is 0.25 and the total axial force is 15 kN. Calculate the power transmitting capacity of the clutch plate at 500 rpm using uniform wear theory and uniform pressure theory. So, we write down the given data. The inner radius is 0.12 meter, outer radius is 0.25 meter, coefficient of friction mu equal to 0.25, the axial force q equal to 15 kN and the speed is 500 rpm. Now, we consider the uniform wear theory. So, for uniform wear theory, the mean radius rm equal to capital R plus small r divided by 2, which is 0.25 plus 0.12 divided by 2 equal to 0.185 meter. And the torque transmitted by the clutch for both side effective, Mt equal to 2 mu q into Rm. So, substituting numerical values, 2 into 0.25 into 15,000 into 0.185 equal to 1387.5 Newton meter. Then we calculate the power transmitted. So, P equal to 2 pi n into Mt divided by 60. So, substituting 2 into 3.14 into 500 into 1387.5 divided by 60 equal to 72,615.2 watts or 72.6 kilowatts. Now, we take the uniform pressure theory. The mean radius for the uniform pressure theory Rm equal to 2 by 3 into capital R cube minus small r cube divided by capital R square minus small r square. So, substituting numerical values, 2 by 3 into 0.25 to the power 3 minus 0.12 to the power 3 divided by 0.25 square minus 0.12 square, calculating the mean radius equal to 0.1926 meter. Then the torque transmitted by the clutch for both side effective, Mt equal to 2 mu q into Rm. So, 2 into 0.25 into 15,000 into 0.1926 equal to 1444.5 Newton meter. Then we calculate the power transmitted by the clutch, P equal to 2 pi n into Mt divided by 60. So, 2 into 3.14 into 500 into 1444.5 divided by 60 equal to 75,595.5 watts or 75.6 kilowatts. So, the answer to the problem, the power transmitted by the clutch for uniform pressure condition 75.6 kilowatts and uniform wear condition 72.6 kilowatts. We take the third example from the cone clutch. This question was appeared in November 2015, May 2015 and May 2006. A power of 20 kilowatt is to be transmitted through a cone clutch at 500 rpm. For uniform wear conditions, find the mean dimensions of the clutch and the shaft. Also determine the axial force required to engage the clutch. Assume coefficient of friction as 0.25. The maximum normal pressure on the friction surface is not to exceed 0.08 MPa and the design stress for the shaft material is 40 MPa. So, write down the given data. So, power equal to 20 kilowatts, speed equal to 500 rpm, coefficient of friction 0.25 and the pressure on the clutch plate 0.08 MPa, pressure for the shaft design or the stress for the shaft design is 40 MPa. So, torque transmitted by the clutch, Mt equal to power into 60 divided by 2 pi n. So, 20,000 into 60 divided by 2 pi into 500 equal to 382 Newton meter and the clutch shaft diameter. So, Mt equal to pi by 16 d cube into Ps. So, substituting, rearranging the terms, d equal to cubic root of 16 into Mt divided by pi into Ps. So, substituting numerical values, cubic root of 16 into 382 divided by 3.14 into 40 into 10 power 6. That is equal to 0.037 meter or 37 millimeter. And dimensions of the clutch using the uniform wear theory. So, we have to assume the face width, it is not given. Normally, we take face width B equal to Rm divided by 2 and we assume the half cone angle alpha equal to 12 degree. Then the mean radius for uniform wear theory Rm equal to capital R plus small r divided by 2. And this is the diagram. So, the capital R is the outer radius of the cone clutch, small r is the inner radius, mean radius is Rm. and we calculate RM equal to capital R plus small r divided by 2, so 0.182 meter. So R plus R, capital R plus small r equal to 0.364. Now for uniform VA theory, the torque transmitted MT equal to 2 pi mu into P into RM square into B. So MT we calculated earlier 382, which is 2 into pi into 0.25 into 0.8 into 10 power 6 into RM square, and we assumed B equal to RM by 2. So this is RM by 2. So the only unknown here is RM. So rearranging the term, RM equal to cubic root of 382 divided by 63,000, which is 0.182 meter. And from the triangle, we take the triangle. So the sine alpha equal to capital R minus small r divided by B. So we calculate capital R minus small r equal to sine alpha into RM divided by 2. So sine 12 into 0.182 divided by 2 equal to 0.019. Now we have two equations, R minus R equal to 0.019, R plus R equal to 0.364, and solving the two equations, capital R equal to 0.1915 meter and small r equal to 0.1725 meter. So the inner radius is 17.25 centimeter and outer radius is 19.15 centimeter. And phase width, we assumed B equal to RM divided by 2, so 0.182 divided by 2 equal to 0.091. meter. And the axial force required, so Qn equal to Q divided by sin alpha, so substituting P into 2 pi RM B sin alpha divided by sin alpha, so the Qn equal to 0.08 into 10 power 6 into 2 pi into 0.182 into 0.091 equal to 8320.75 Newton, and the axial force to engage the clutch Qe equal to Qn into mu cos alpha plus sin alpha. So 8320.75 into 0.25 into cos 12 plus sin 12 equal to 3764.7 Newton. And the answers to the problem, we write down the answers. Shaft diameter is 37 millimeter. Inner radius of the clutch equal to 17.25 centimeter. Outer radius of the clutch equal to 19.15 centimeter. Width of the clutch plate B equal to 9.1 centimeter. And axial force to engage the clutch is 3764.7 Newton. And the next example from May 2011 question paper, a cone clutch has a cone angle of 11.5 degree, a mean frictional diameter of 320 millimeter and a face width of 60 mm. The clutch is to transmit a torque of 200 Newton meter. The coefficient of friction is 0.26. Find the activating force and the pressure using the assumption of uniform pressure. So we write down the given data from the problem. RM equal to mean radius equal to 0.32 meter, face width equal to 0.06 meter, torque transmitted is 200 Newton meter, coefficient of friction 0.26, alpha equal to 11.5 degrees. And for uniform pressure theory, the torque transmitted, so MT equal to mu Q RM divided by sin alpha. So the axial force Q equal to sin alpha into MT divided by mu into RM. So substituting numerical values, sin of 11.5 into 200 divided by 0.26 into 0.32 equal to 479.25 Newton. Then we calculate the total pressure on the clutch plate, P equal to Q divided by RM into B. So 479.25 divided by 0.32 into 0.06 equal to 24,961 Newtons per meter square. So the answer to the problem, the activating force Q equal to 479.25 Newton and the total pressure on the clutch plate P equal to 24,961 Newtons per meter square. We take next example from the question paper November 2006, example number 5. An engine developing 45 kilowatt at 1000 rpm is fitted with a cone clutch built inside the flywheel. The cone has a face angle of 12.5 degrees. And the maximum mean diameter is 500 millimeter, coefficient of friction 0.2, normal pressure on the clutch face is not to exceed 0.1 newtons per millimeter square. Determine the face width required and the axial spring force necessary to engage the clutch. So we write down the given data, power equal to 45 kilowatt and speed equal to 1000 rpm, alpha cone angle, half cone angle is 12.5 degree, coefficient of friction mu equal to 0.2 and the mean radius is 0.5 meter and the pressure is 0.1 newtons per millimeter square. So, the torque transmitted by the clutch from the power given, we have to calculate the torque transmitted. Mt equal to P into 60 divided by 2 pi n. So, 45,000 into 60 divided by 2 pi into 1000 equal to 430 newton meter. The torque transmitted is 430 newton meter. Then the axial spring force required for uniform wear theory. So, Q equal to sin alpha into Mt divided by mu into Rm, which is sin of 12.5 into 430 divided by 0.2 into 0.5 equal to 930.7 newton. The face width of the cone clutch assuming uniform wear theory. So, B equal to Q divided by 2 pi mu into P Rm sin alpha. So, substitute numerical values, B equal to 930.7 divided by 2 pi into 0.2 into 0.1 into 10 power 6 into 0.5 into sin 12.5 equal to 0.068 meter. So, the answer to the problem, the face width of the clutch is 6.8 centimeter and the axial spring force Q equal to 930.7 newton. We stop here. So, these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering subject. You can refer to it. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the video for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another set of problems on the clutch design in the next video lecture. Thank you.